يا مفتى وتنحت جسمك الساعات نحتا وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتا تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها حتى إذا مت انتبهتا فكم ذا أنت مخدوع وحتى متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا إن نهيت وإن أمرتا ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب به مقاتل من أردتا وكنز لا تخاف عليه لصا خفيف الحمل يوجد.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على سيدنا محمدٍ وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسانٍ إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am your host Karim AbuZaid, and I welcome you to another edition of the virtual Right Believe series, سلسلة العقيدة الصحيحة, the virtual Right Believe series, to distinguish it from the Right Believe series which I presented earlier in a masjid, brothers and sisters in Islam. Today, inshallah, we have a very noble subject, which is the subject of the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is lecture number 7 in that series, brothers and sisters in Islam. Today, we will be talking about the methodology regarding understanding Allah's names and attributes. The methodology regarding al-asma wa-sifat, the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We introduced the subject of the names and the attributes previously, and the significance and the importance of this subject. And last session, if you remember, I went with you through history, addressing the how the Ummah differed regarding this subject, how Muslims were influenced by the teachings of the nations who reverted to Islam, whether the speculative speech, ilm al-kalam, philosophy, or the ideology of the nations, and they started manipulating and changing the inherited understanding of the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, when we talk about the names and the attributes today, we're not explaining them and what they mean. We're talking about the method to comprehend them, to understand them. The way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his companions and their students understood them. I want to let you know, if you're giving that part of knowledge, it is a good sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you to understand the proper knowledge related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide our tongue to explain this subject properly, and protect our tongue and our pen and our hearts from error, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Because imagine the mistake in this subject is a big mistake, not a simple one. Let me first do what I normally do. Welcome our first brothers and sisters who sign us who sign up with us, and then we'll start the lecture right away, inshallah. But meanwhile, if I can also ask one of our brothers to try our Skype, so this way we have the Skype working as well, inshallah. So this way we are in good shape, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, and ready to go. But let me welcome Abu Bakr Muhammad. Assalamu alaikum, brother Abu Bakr. Good to have you. Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi adhan. Good to have you, adhan. Jazakallahu khairan. I guess we're working, huh? Can you hear me, adhan? I guess adhan can hear me, alhamdulillah. Sister Muhammad, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sister Amina Shenli, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Anas Mia, wa alaykum assalam. Brother Atila from Toronto, wa alaykum assalam. Shuaib, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our brother Adam, our sister Rahima, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Benazir Basha, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Gary, wa alaykum assalam. Abdul Qadir al-Albani, wa alaykum assalam. Hajra Hassan, and the Street Bath, and our sister Tara, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is so far who we have on the broadcast. Inshallah, may Allah send us the rest. Maybe they are asleep and they will wake up, inshallah. But we're ready to go, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. I know a lot of the brothers watch this later because of the time difference in Europe and the rest of the world, inshallah. But like we say, the knowledge is there, inshallah. So the methodology regarding Allah's names and attributes. Like we said before, brothers and sisters in Islam, we're trying to follow the footsteps of the Sahaba and the footsteps of the predecessors in understanding the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A little introduction here. The subject of the divine attributes and names is one of the greatest requirements of Islam and one of the most noble of all sciences, and one of the most critical in the minds of people. Great disputes have occurred in the subject due to what the innovators invented by engaging and delving into Allah's essence, names, and attributes without knowledge. And I've given you an idea last lecture of famous names in that field, the people who led Muslims astray in this area, brothers and sisters in Islam. The names of Allah are all those names that refer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and refer to one of his perfect attributes that exist in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as Al-Qadir, the all-powerful. So the all-powerful is a name, but it refers to an attribute which is what? Might and power. might and power. So the name Al-Qadir, the all-powerful, refers to an attribute which is Al-Qudra, the might and the power. The name of Allah, Al-Alim, the all-knowing, even though, so the name is Al-Alim, the all-knowing, it refers to an attribute of knowledge, the attributes of knowledge. The name of Allah, Al-Hakim, the most wise, refers to an attribute of wisdom. Al-Sami', the all-hearing, refers to the attribute of hearing. Al-Basir, the all-seeing, refers to vision and seeing. These names refer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and his qualities of knowledge, wisdom, hearing, and sight. The attributes refer to one thing, which is the attribute itself. So a name of Allah indicates two things, the name and the attribute. But the attribute requires a name. Some of you are already confused. Let me take you to another level. If you're asked, like a student of knowledge, we always say asma wa sifat, the names and the attributes of Allah. Here is a question for you. What is the difference, or what are the differences between the names of Allah and the attributes of Allah? Okay, that's a question. That's the first question we want to answer tonight. We need to know that. What do we mean when we say the names? What do we mean when we say the attributes? I told you a minute ago that the name of Allah, As-Sami', the all-hearing, that's a name. As-Sami' is the all-hearing. It refers to an attribute which is called what? Hearing. Al-Basir, the all-seeing, it refers to Allah himself and it refers to an attribute of Allah, which is the sight. The sight. You're getting that? So let's answer the question, brothers and sisters in Islam. What is the difference between the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The first difference, brothers and sisters in Islam, right here, is the name, or the names refer to two things. Refer to the essence, to Allah. As-Sami' is Allah. Al-Basir is Allah. And it also refers to an attribute. So when you say a name, then the name refers to Allah himself, the essence of Allah, an attribute of Allah. But what about the attribute? The attribute refers to one thing, which is the attribute. Al-Sam'a, Al-Basar. And for you to come up with an attribute, you must have a name. You're getting that? You must have a name. So that's the first difference. The first difference. A name refers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and an attribute. Or maybe attributes. One name, Al-Hakim, the all-wise, requires knowledge too. The all-wise require, khibra, experience, if we may use this pertaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one name could mean more than one attribute. But for you to produce an attribute, you must have a name. Or Allah tells you this is an attribute. That's the first difference. The attributes refer to one thing, which is the attribute itself. So a name of Allah, look at this white bullet there. A name of Allah indicates two things, and an attribute indicates only one thing. So it is said, a name includes an attribute, and an attribute requires a name. That's the first difference. But the second difference, very important. Pay attention to this. you may derive attributes from the names, but not vice versa. I'll explain, no panic. Like a minute ago, I said As-Sami'a, the all-hearing. What attribute did we derive from the name of Allah, the all-hearing? Hearing. Al-Hakim, that's a name. Al-Hakim is a name of Allah. What attribute did we derive? Derive, يعني اشتقاق, اشتققنا. Wisdom, the attribute of wisdom. طيب, what attribute did we derive from al-basir? Sight, the all-seer, sight. But we cannot derive names from attributes. One of the things when we debate with Christian and Jews, and if they want to insult Allah to make you upset, they tell you, listen, I don't like to worship a God who blots, a God who deceives. If you read the Mus'haf, وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهِ, they blotted and Allah blotted. So now the attribute of blotting is confirmed for Allah. The question, can you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the blotter? No, you can't. You cannot. Astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah. Say subhanallah. Why? Because we do not derive names from the attributes. But this is what we call sifat muqabala, an attribute of facing, a confrontational. Because imagine the created beings, they blot. What is blotting? What does blotting means? What does blotting means? What does blotting means? At-tadbiru bi-khafa, that you do something in secret, that no one knows about it. That's what blotting is. That you scheme, you cook something with, to your enemy, or to somebody that you're trying to harm without them knowing it. So imagine their blood, that created blood, and Allah doesn't know about it. No, Allah blots too. Meaning Allah knows what they are doing. Meanwhile, they do not know what Allah is doing. You're getting that. So it's sifat muqabala. It's an attribute to face, confront. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ. Indeed, the hypocrites, they think, the hypocrites, they deceive Allah, and Allah deceives them. Now the people, they say, Allah is the deceiver. Can you say Allah the deceiver? No, you can't say that. You cannot say that. Why? Because of that, we cannot derive names for Allah from attributes, from actions. We don't do that. You're getting the point. But now, does Allah deceive? Yes. Well, what would you say if the hypocrites, what is deceiving? What is deception? What do you mean by deception here? That you try to trick the one in front of you, that the hypocrites are tricking Allah. Can you say that? Astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah. The attribute here is the attribute. But the rule that I want you to memorize, that I want you to understand, that you may derive attributes from one name, but you cannot do vice versa. Here it is. We may derive attributes from the names, but we cannot derive names from the attributes. Say, for example, they blot and Allah blots. The Quran affirms the attribute of blotting to Allah. But we cannot derive the name the blotter from the attribute of blotting. The coming and the descending are attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was mentioned in the Quran, but we cannot derive names from these attributes. We cannot call Allah the comer, the descendant. Of course, this differs from the names of Allah, which refer to an attribute by itself. So this is the second difference, brothers and sisters, in Islam. So what was the first difference? Huh? Come on, students, what?
A name refers to two things: Allah, the essence, that, the divine essence of Allah. When I say Sami', who's a Sami'? Allah. And it refers to an attribute of Allah as well. Two things. An attribute refers by itself. It stands by itself. طيب. The second difference between the names and the attributes, we may derive attributes from the name, but we cannot do vice versa. We cannot derive names from the attributes. Number three, consequently, the attributes are way more than the names. Which is bigger now? The attribute, if every name has an attribute or more than one attribute, so the attributes are what? Many. Our knowledge of Allah's attributes is vaster than our knowledge of His names, since each name implies an attribute, but not all the attributes double as a name. For example, Allah has attributes indicate some of His numerous actions, like coming, going, taking, catching, using force. We attribute them to Allah because they are mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah, but they don't have names. But we do not refer to Him by names that indicate that. Like I said, I cannot call Allah the blotter. I cannot call Him the common. I cannot call Him the descendant, because there is no name. You understand? But the attribute is there. Consequently, the attributes are way more than the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last difference, brothers and sisters in Islam, when we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we use the names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدُعُوهُ بِهَا. To Allah belongs the most beautiful name, so call upon Allah using these names. When you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't use the attribute by itself, but you call يَا سَمِيعَ يَا بَصِيرَ يَا قَوِيَّ يَا حَمِيدَ يَا مَجِيدَ يَا غَنِيَّ. So when you say يَا, you use a name. But for you to use the attribute, you must use something before it. You cannot use the attribute. You cannot call upon Allah saying, O sight, O seeing, O wisdom. You cannot call upon Allah using the attribute by itself, but using something with it. Like, Allahumma bi'ilmika al-ghaybi, bi'ilmika al-ghayba. وَقُدْرَتِكَ عَلَى الْخَلْقِ by, like, في سنن النساء, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly, and this is the second difference, the third difference that we have, brothers and sisters in Islam. So this is a little warm-up here. We differentiated between the names and the attributes. A name refers to Allah and an attribute, but the attribute refers to just an attribute. We cannot derive names from the attributes, but we can derive attributes from the names. We call upon Allah straight using the names, but for me to call upon Allah using the attribute, I must add something before it. These are the differences, brothers and sisters in Islam. Okay, ready to go. Next step. Come on, brothers. Come on, sisters. This is a very beautiful subject. Wallahi. And you may have to watch that more over and over, 3-4 times to grasp it, to get it. But if Allah gives it to you, it's beautiful. It's beauty. Again, we're not explaining the names and the attributes. We're not like selecting certain names and explaining. No, we're showing you how to understand them, how to comprehend them. Because there are people who went astray in this area. And there are people who don't know how to understand them. And there are people who don't care. You understand? But we need brothers and sisters who care. So the second question, so the first question was, what are the differences between the names and the attributes? And we came up with three differences at least, 3-4. Now the next question is, what do we mean by Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat? Tawheed al-Asma'i, you always hear Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. What is Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat? How can you achieve tawheed, oneness of Allah, in the area of the names and the attributes? Here it is. What is tawheed al-asma' wa-sifat? To affirm that which Allah has affirmed for himself, or that which his messenger has affirmed for him, from the names and the attributes in the most perfect manner, without which suits his majesty and greatness, laysa kamithlihi shay, without turning to anything from tahrif, distortion, ta'atil, negation, takyif, asking how, tamthil, resemblance. Ah, oh, man, this is heavy, heavy duty stuff. I know some of you are going to leave and go, man, this is tough. But understanding the subject, brothers and sisters in Islam, is a key. Is a key to understand the Quran. Imagine this. Let me break that definition down for you. And the definition is not done yet. First of all, you need to understand this. No one can talk about Allah except Allah and His Messenger. ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء. They have no access to his knowledge except that which he wills, which is the wahi, the revelation, what he revealed to his messenger, the Quran and the Sunnah, basically. So that's why I look at the first piece of the definition, to affirm that which Allah has affirmed for himself, and that which his messenger has affirmed for him from the names and the attributes. تثبت ما أثبته الله لنفسه في قرآنه أو على لسان نبيه في سنته. Allah said, I hear, then he hears. I see, then he sees. Okay. Now, you affirm it in the best, the most perfect manner, which suits his majesty, his greatness, subhanah. You cannot understand it in a way that is human, because Allah is above everyone. No one is like him. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. No one is like him at all, once it comes to his divine essence, once it comes to his names, once it comes to his attributes, once it comes to his actions, no one. So you affirm what Allah affirmed for himself in the most perfect manner, which suits his greatness, his majesty. Don't play with it without what? Distortion. You cannot distort it. You cannot change it. That's what distortion is. And we're going to come to these terms. You're not supposed to figure out how. And the first statement that I want you to memorize today. لا يعلم كيف الله إلا الله. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows who Allah is. How does Allah hear? How does Allah see? You don't know. We don't know. And don't try. You must cut off all hopes that you can reach the reality and the nature of the attribute of the names of Allah. But what if shaitan comes and plays with your head? And shaitan does. Shaitan comes and he makes you visualize Allah in a certain way. Say, Subhanallah. First thing that you should do, stop the thought, stop the visualization, stop the comprehension, and say, Subhanallah. What does Subhanallah mean? Meaning Allah is above that. كُلُّ مَا دَارَ بِبَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ بِخِلَافِ ذَلِكَ. Whatever your brain produces of how Allah is, his names are, his attributes are, Say Subhanallah. Say Subhanallah. Say Subhanallah, because Allah is above that. Allah is above that.
لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير.
Visions, minds cannot comprehend them. So, you affirm without distortion, without resemblance, without takif, and without tajsim. And we're going to come to this. So you affirm. So this is the first half. So without what? Resemblance, asking how, without negation, without distortion. Let's use to the second half of the definition, which is the white bullet. To negate also that which, there is a typo here, Allah has negated from himself or his messenger negated from him. What do we mean by that? You see, brothers and sisters in Islam, when we affirm an attribute for Allah, we must have an evidence. Meaning what? For me to say Allah is a Sami', I must have a Quran or authentic Sunnah to say that. Why did I say Allah is Sami'? Because there is a verse in Surah Ash-Shura which says, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ. He is the all-hearing. That is why I'm telling you Allah is the all-hearing, because I have an evidence. Likewise, pay attention here. A lot of you may hear this for the first time. Likewise, if you want to negate, what does it mean negate? Nafi. If you want to dismiss, if you want to deny an attribute from Allah, if you want to say Allah is not that, you must have an evidence too. Hatta naf. So you negate with evidence. You cannot run your mouth. Because somehow, somewhat, if you want to insult somebody, you could actually insult somebody this way. Like, with all due respect here, I have brother Attila from Toronto, and I love you, brother Attila, but I want to bring the point across to the brothers here. I say, okay, brother Attila doesn't go to the nightclubs. Brother Attila doesn't smoke marijuana. Brother Attila doesn't... I'm negating. I'm dismissing what? But in a way, I'm insulting. Why are you saying that? Likewise, you cannot negate an attribute from Allah without what? Without an evidence. Tab, take for example, can I say Allah doesn't sleep? Can I say that? Yes, I can. I can. What is your evidence? Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. لا. So negation, there is an evidence. Can I say Allah doesn't die? Yes, I can. Some of you may say, come on. Yes, I can say that. Why?
وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت وسبح بحمده.
Place your trust upon the one who does not die, the ever living who does not die. You're getting that? So the negation, the point of the negation here, you must have an evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah. But with a little twist here, look at this here. To negate that which Allah has negated from himself, or that which his messenger negated from him, from the names and the attributes, but along with believing that its fully perfect opposite is confirmed for Allah, the highest. Like if I say Allah doesn't die, I affirm life for Allah in the most perfect manner. And I'll explain that in a minute. But this is just the definition. Obviously here, to achieve the above mentioned definition, we must do three things. Affirm, negate, and restrain or halt regarding vague terms that we cannot run our mouth. Are you ready to go on? So the first step for you to achieve unification, oneness, tawheed, illah, in the area of the names and the attributes, you must affirm. تثبت ما أثبته الله لنفسه. You affirm, and if Allah said he is that, you affirm it. You affirm it. But be careful, there are four things people went astray. Stay away from them. Affirmation of everything which Allah affirmed for himself in the Quran, or his messenger affirmed for him, for Allah, in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, without. Avoid these four things. Number one, negation, ta'til. Two, distortion, tahrif, the red one. Distorting their meanings, completely or partially. Three, without tamthil, tajseem, tashbih, which is saying Allah's face looks like that. This attribute is like that. Takyif, without takyif, seeking to know the nature or the reality of the attributes. We're good? Okay, I'm going to keep this on the screen for a little bit for you. So you affirm without what? Stay away from negation. لا تكن من المعطلة. Without تحريف. لا تكن من المؤولة. Without تجسيم. لا تكن من المجسمة. Without تكييف. لا تكن من المكيفة. Which is similar to تجسيم. That you say the attribute of Allah is like that. Allah does this. Allah descends like this. Allah comes like this. That's why sometimes brothers... Sheikh, you know, you ask this, you know, just to show you what is the subject, and you hear that question often. Sheikh, you know, you say Allah descends the last third of the night. According to who? According to America? According to Europe? I mean, I'm still here at 6:30 here, 6:38 here in Denver. Some people out there, they are, which third? You see, you're trying to seek how? You're trying to find, no, you're not supposed to do that. You're not supposed to do that. You see, لَمْ يَتَعَبَّدَكَ اللَّهُ بِالْكَيْفِيَّةِ. Allah did not ask you to figure out how his attributes are. Just believe in it the way it is. That's why we say he descends in a way that suits his majesty and his greatness. And leave it. مَرِّرْهَا. Like they say. And remember this line. لَا يَعْلَمْ كَيْفَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Only Allah knows how Allah is. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ready? Let's learn what ta'til is. So you affirm without ta'til. What is ta'til? Negation. This is done by negating divine attributes and denying their existence. Negating the perfection of Allah by denying his names and attributes. Negating the proper conduct towards Allah by abandoning worship or barring the created from its creator, such as those who deny the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the universe and claim that it developed and evolved. Allahu Akbar. What does it mean, negation, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you say that Allah doesn't have, you can do this completely. You say that Allah doesn't have any attributes, doesn't have any names. That's why, see, there is a complete and partial. We have two sects in Islam. Al-Mu'tazila, Al-Jahmiyyah, they say Allah doesn't have any attributes at all. Doesn't have any names at all. What are you going to do with the Quran, you know? Imagine, just to show you that when you approach the Quran with that wicked understanding, I think one of them made that statement. That man, every time I come across Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa, the most merciful, did istiwa upon the throne, did istiwa upon the throne. He says, وَدَدْتُ لَوْ أَنِّي حَكَكْتُهَا مِنَ الْمُصْحَفِ. I wished I could erase it from the Mus'haf. Because he cannot do it. He cannot accept it. Imagine that. Imagine this. Al-Mu'attila. The negators, we call them al-mu'attila, ta'thil, that you negate completely the names of Allah, like the Jahmi, like the Mu'tazili, or you do it partially, like al-Asha'ira. الأشاعرة, which is the mainstream, just to show you the mainstream, like the multitude of Muslims, because they don't know these names and attributes, they don't know this subject. They actually negate, they only affirm certain, whether 7, whether 13, whether 20, we can debate that. Or they can debate that with themselves. And we're going to come to this in more details in the future, but they say Allah doesn't have any names. So, this is the second line that I wanted to memorize today. المعطل يعبد عدما. So remember the first line, لا يعلم كيف الله إلا الله. Only Allah knows how Allah is. Only Allah knows. That's why you cannot run your mouth. You cannot run your head. المعطل, the second one. المعطل يعبد عدما. The one who negates the attributes is worshipping what? Nobody. It's like, oh, brother, my wife, alhamdulillah, you know, she giving birth to my son. Beautiful. It's beautiful boy. Okay, what are his attributes? Can you describe him? Oh, he doesn't have any attributes. He doesn't hear. He doesn't see. He doesn't talk. Why the fitna of khalq al-Qur'an? Why the fitna of khalq al-Qur'an? Remember that fitna of the Qur'an is created, not speech. Why? Because that's in the area. The people who negated the attributes, al-Mu'tazili, they negated the attributes. So you can do this completely and you can do this partially, brothers and sisters in Islam. Here it is. Complete ta'til, negation. This is complete and utter negation, such as that al-Jahmi and al-Mu'tazili. And we mentioned the names, Al-Jahm ibn Safwan, Al-Ja'd ibn Dirham. The partial ta'til, which is partial negation, this is like the ta'til of Al-Ash'ari, who negated some of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the second thing that you should avoid, so you cannot cancel out all or partial. As long as the name has a presence in the Quran or in the Sunnah, uthbituhu, I affirm it. Allah said that he is that. Allah said he has a hand. Allah said he has eyes. Allah said that he hears. So when you negate it, you're belying the Quran. You're saying this Quran did not say right about Allah. You're getting that. That's a dangerous statement. You're making a statement which is dangerous. So the first thing that you must avoid is what? Ta'til. What is the second thing? Tahrif, distortion. What is distortion? So they say, okay, you know what? We're going to accept it. But this is not what it means. The hand doesn't mean a hand. But let's give those, and those are the Ash'ari, those are the Ash'aira. And, you know, and let's give them the benefit of the doubt. Yani, let's be think positive of them. Why they did this? They say, listen, when I say a hand, when I use the hand, the head, what is the first thing which comes in your mind, spring out of your mind? The human hand. No. Who said that? I can't do that either. We're going to come to this, tamthil. We're going to come to the tajseem, tashbih. We don't do resemblance. We understand the attribute. Here's the third rule. Here's the third terminology. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ. Nothing is like Allah. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. So he hears and he sees, but not like us. And think about it. What is the difference between our hearing and Allah's hearing? Let's take the hearing, for example. Hearing. You see, I can only hear you now, in that place, in that room, where I am, where my studio is. But Allah, imagine, can hear everybody. He can hear the people in Denver, the people in Colorado, the people in London, the people in China, at the same time. At any time, he hears them. Hadith Abi Dhar al-Ghifari, radiyallahu an, Hadith al-Ilahi. If the first of you and the last of you, jinn or ins, the two races, would stand in one place, and each one of you will make a request, Allah will hear us at the same time and he will give us what we ask for, which is not the same. We're not going to ask for the same thing. You're going to ask for a car. I'm going to ask for a house. He's going to ask for a... he's going to give you the same thing at the same time.
مَا خَلْقُكُمْ وَلَا بَعْثُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ.
You're getting that? We understand there is no need to distort, to make tahreef. Because those people, al-Asha'ira, they say, well, we're using the hand, like the hand. The hand, don't say Allah doesn't have a hand. Astaghfirullah. But the hand means power. Allah comes, the command of Allah comes. Allah descends, His mercy descends. So they take the apparent meaning to another meaning of their choice. Why? Because they're afraid they are doing resemblance. No, who said that? Who said that? Watch this. Tahrif is to watch the words from their correct meanings to invented meanings without any evidence. Tahrif is a form of deviation in interpreting Allah's names and attributes, because one interpret the text regarding the attributes upon other than their true interpretation. By doing so, they change. And they claim that they are changing the meanings from one probable understanding to another one, without any evidence, except that which is from the opinion and the intellect of men. And that opened the door, brothers and sisters, to speak about Allah in a way. Let's give them the benefit of the doubt. Al-Asha'iri in particular, they claim that they do this because they don't want us to end up picturing Allah in a human way. Because a lot of these attributes are similar to the human attributes. But who said that we understand these attributes in that context? You see, we understand the attributes. That's why we say what? Allah sees in a way that suits His majesty and His greatness. ليس كمثله شيء. Even, يا إخوة, like if I tell you right now, والله المثل الأعلى here. The hand, the human hand, the hand of a donkey, the hand of a dog, the hand of a cat, the hand of a bird, are they the same? They look the same? And we're talking about created things here. No, they are different. They are not the same. Why? Because the essence is different. The body is different. The hand, the human body is like this. The bird, like this. Because the essence, with Allah, His divine essence, لا. So we can't. Not المشاركة في الألفاظ لا يعني المعاني. That is why Ibn Abbas said the only share between the world and Jannah is the names. Yeah, we're talking about bananas, but it's not وَأُتُوا بِهِ مُتَشَابِهَةً. It looked like the bananas in the world, but it's not the bananas in the world. No, it's just the name. Because if I come and describe, the Jannah to you in a way that, like if I come, okay, let me, brothers, describe Jannah for you. Jannah has, what are you talking? لا, Jannah has bananas, Jannah has drinks. Jannah has fruits, Jannah has food, I'm describing Jannah in a way that you understand, but it doesn't mean that it is, you're getting the point. I think you're getting the point. You're smart. ليس كمثلي شيء أو سميع البصير. There are three ways that a person may do تحريف. تحريف المعاني, like let's say, the people who refuse to affirm that Allah speaks. That Allah speaks. So they end up doing what? They work on the grammars.
وَلَمَّا جَاءَ مُوسَى لِمِيقَاتِنَا وَكَلَّمَهُ رَبَّهُ.
Look at this. كَلَّمَهُ رَبَّهُ. So they affirm the speech to the created, to Musa, that Musa spoke to Allah, and Allah did not speak back to him. So imagine, look at how wicked this is, that you affirm an attribute to the created being, But you don't affirm it for the creator, for the one who created. So what they end up doing, they're playing with the grammars. Sometimes they actually change the wording. Istawa ala al-arsh. Istawa. So they add istawla, conquered, took over the throne. So they end up, and sometimes they do the literal meaning, like the hand, they say it's power, here it is. Literally by altering the wordings of the names and the attributes, by adding to them, subtracting from them, by changing the grammatical construction, such as, and Allah spoke directly to Musa, like I said, or by changing the meaning, and this is the most common, by the way, of the word, through giving it a metaphorical majaz meaning and not taking it literally. His hand represents his power and his bestowal of bounty, such as the interpretation this requires the negation of the attribute. So this is tahrif. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, brothers and sisters in Islam, we attest the attributes mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah, and we take it in a face value. Two hands, استوى على العرش, يتنزل, سبحانه. We understand it in a way without comparing them to the human attributes or interpreting them in a way that leads to negation. Look at Imam al-Shafi'i, I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what revelation tells about him in the manner he intended, and I believe in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the manner he intended. وذلك يا أخوة سبحان الله يعني the Arabs, you know, the Muslims understood these, the names, and they never questioned. They never said what it means. They never said that. Have you ever had a hadith where a companion came to the Prophet and said, what does استوى على العرش means? They understood what ما هو الاستوى على واستقر in a way that suits his majesty. So this is the second thing that we must avoid, brothers and sisters. Example of tahrif, such as changing the meanings of al-yadan, the two hands, meaning power or bounty, or to change the meaning of al-istawa, the ascension, meaning istawla. Al-dahik, Allah laughs. Allah laughs in a way that suits His Majesty. It means when He laughs, that means Allah is pleased with you, then He will give you the reward. You see, you take a word from its meaning to an apparent meaning, from the apparent meaning to a hidden meaning. Okay, let's finish up here. So we'll finish the affirmation today. And next we'll do the negation, inshallah, brothers and sisters in Islam. But here is the affirmation. You affirm without what? Ta'til. Number two, without what? Distortion. Number three, without tajseem, without tamthil, without tashbih. That you cannot say Allah does this in that way. Affirming likeness, a likeness with something, such as, if a person was to say the hand of Allah is like the human hand, we don't say that. We don't say that because we understand the hand, the attributes, the names in a way that suits His Majesty. Right? ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. All right? Moving forward. Example of tamthil, and I love this, brothers and sisters in Islam, and pay attention here, if you're living in the West, you should take this to them. Actually, the Christian and the Jews were not meant to do tajseem of Allah, because that's their guilt right here. That's what they distorted. They said Allah comes down in the flesh. They made tajseem. They say Allah embodies Jesus. Jesus in Allah, and that's why they are saying. Look at the first command. I wanted to look at the green bullet. The first command in the Ten Commandments. This is how it reads, by the way. Some of you may not know that. And God spoke all these words. I am the Lord, your God, who brought you out of Egypt, out of land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. So this is one, which is what? La ilaha illallah. That's one. But look at this now. Look at this. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven, above or on the earth, beneath or in the water below. And call it God, and you bow down to it. You're not supposed to make an image of Allah You see, that's what they did. They said Allah comes down in Jesus. You see, that's the danger of Allah's everywhere statement. You're getting that. That you make an image. And that's the justification that the disbelievers of Mecca had. You see, the disbelievers of Mecca, they never denied the existence of Allah, but they said Allah embodies their idols. We don't worship Lat, we don't worship Al-Uzza, we don't worship Manat, but we worship the spirit inside them, the spirit of God, yeah. You're getting that. So that's what we call tajseem. Here is the fourth statement. Remember, لا يعلم كيف الله إلا الله ليس كمثله شيء وسميع البصير لم يكن له كفوا أحد المجسم المعطل يعبد عدما. The one who negates his worship in the world. Likewise, والمجسم يعبد وثنا. And if you resemble Allah to his created beings, then you're worshiping an idol. والمجسم يعبد وثنا. The one who says Allah looks like this, he is certainly worshiping an idol. He made an idol of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like the Christians, they bow down to Mary, the icon of Maryam, icon of Jesus. Or the people who bow down because they say Allah is inside that. And that is what we call tamthil. The last thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, then we're done. I know that we're not going to have time for questions and answers today, but the last thing, I wanted to finish this today. Ithbat, that you affirm what Allah affirmed for himself or his messenger without, number one, negation. Two, without distortion. Number three, without tamthil, tajseem, tashbih, resemblance. Number four, takif, that you say Allah is like that. Or you try to figure out. What is takif, brothers and sisters in Islam? Is to mention how an attribute, such as someone saying Allah's hand is like that. Sometimes a person may even combine this takif with resemblance, which is both subhanallah, brothers and sisters in Islam. Subhanallah, here is the last statement that you should know. يجب الكف عن التكييف وده الشنقيطي قال هذا الكلام تقديرا بالجنان أو تقريرا باللسان أو تحريرا بالبنان. You must cut off any hope that you can reach the reality or the nature of who Allah is. You must give up that. Whether taqdiran bil janan, that your brain, okay, like the people who smoke dope and get, okay, you know what, let me figure out how Allah looks like. Okay, say subhanallah, Allah is above that. You must give up that. And you don't have to do it. The thing is, lam yata'abbadaka Allahu bil kayfi. Allah did not ask us to figure out how he looks like. Just understand, believe in a way that suits his majesty, his names and attributes. Brother, that's it. You're getting the point. Or qawlan bil lisan, that you describe Allah with your tongue. You say Allah is this, Allah is that. You run your mouth without what? Without, because we cannot talk about Allah without what? Without having an evidence from the Quran or the Sunnah that says Allah is this, Allah is that. أو تحريرا بالبنان, or you hold a, okay, you draw something like this and you say this is Allah. Those three. لا استغفر الله سبحان الله سبحان الله كل ما دار ببالك فالله بخلاف ذلك. Everything that goes into your brain, Allah is above that. And shaitan comes and he plays with your head and he makes you visualize Allah, and sometimes he make you visualize Allah in a very bad way. Say subhanallah. Especially the people who have that issue with al-waswas. So alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters in Islam, I know this is very academic, but hey, you know, if you really want to understand the subject, but at least we covered the first half of the definition, the affirmation. Next, we're going to do the negation, and we want to do the third part, which is, what if there is no affirmation? What if there is no negation? Then you stop. Some people come up with sort of, Allah does this. I can't negate, I can't affirm. I can. Because I must have an evidence. So, inshallah, bidnillahi ta'ala, maybe next lecture, inshallah, I will allow more time tomorrow. We have the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
فت فؤادك الأيام فتى، وتنحت جسمك الساعات نحتى، وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق، ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت، أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر، أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتى، تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها، حتى إذا مت انتبهتا، فكم ذا أنت مخدوع وحتى، متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى، أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا، إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا، إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا، إن نهيت وإن أمرتا، ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها، ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا، وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا، ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا، ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا، ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا، هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو، تصيب به مقاتل من أردتا، وكنز لا تخاف عليه لصا، خفيف الحمل يوجد حيث كنتا.